Hello everyone, welcome back to the development of lateral surfaces session. So in the previous session I had taken 5 problems on development of lateral surfaces. In this session we will continue with the problems. We will take up the next problem, that is the 6th problem on a square prism. So once you had the name square prism, it should be solved using the parallel line method in the case of development. So the problem goes like this: a square prism of base side 40 mm and axis length 65 mm is resting on HP on one of its base with all the vertical faces being equally inclined to VP. It is cut by an inclined plane 60 degrees to HP and perpendicular to VP, and is passing through a point on the axis at a distance 15 mm from the top face. Draw the development of the lower portion of the prism. So this is what the problem. Now this is the top view and the front view of the said problem. You are familiar with writing the top view and the front view of the said problem with the given condition. We will introduce section plane now. The section plane is 60 degrees to HP and perpendicular to VP, and it should pass through a point on the axis at the distance of 15 mm from the top face. So this is the height of the prism, which is 65 mm, and this is the side of the prism, which is 40 mm. Now this is the axis. Here axis and the edge are overlapping, so it is 15 mm from the top face. From here measure 15 mm, 15. So the section plane should pass through this particular point, and it should be 60 degrees to HP. So it should be something like this: perpendicular to HP and 60 degrees to, perpendicular to VP and 60 degrees to HP. So you will get something like this. Okay, if you construct it to a scale, if you take 60 degree here, the line, the section plane line will pass through something like this. Find where this will be the retained portion. I will use different colors. So this will be the retained portion. Only this much is the retained portion. So you need to draw the development of only the retained portion of the prism, that is the lower portion of the prism. Top portion will be cut off by the section plane. Now just have a look. I need to name the edges A, B, C, D. I start with this particular point A, B, C and D, so that this will be A dash, B dash in bracket D dash, and this is C dash. Okay, so now one thing you must observe here is the section plane is cutting the base edge at this particular point. The section plane is cutting the lateral edges at this point and then this point, but the section plane is cutting the base edge at this particular point. You just have a look at this particular point. At this point the section plane is cutting the base edge also of the prism. Now look at the base edge fashion of writing. It is parallel, it appears parallel to XY line. This base edge is appears parallel to XY line. Therefore you will get the true length of this in the other view. You need to keep in mind that in the development each and every line should be in its true length, and the lines concept what speaks about is, if a line is appeared parallel to one of the plane, then you will get the true length of that in the other plane. So here this is appearing parallel to XY line, the base edge, so that you will get the true length of this in the other view. So this CD is the true length of this particular point, CD as well as BC. There are two base edges here. Therefore to get the true length of this particular point, you need to drop a projector from this particular point
and you must measure this particular distances. I will write D this side. So you must measure this distance, and also you must measure this distance.
Okay. Now if you try to measure that particular distance to the scale, you will get 12.87.
This is 12.87,
and the another one you will get it as this one. You will get it as 11.9. That you must measure whatever. If it is 11, 12, or some x, y, z, whatever, you must measure this particular distance. Okay, so while drawing the development, you should not take this particular point, this distance, you should take instead this one, because this is the true length of the base edge. We start the development now. We need to take the extended line, which is the parallel line method. Now you can keep the convenient distance between the front view and the development. So I have written here, keeping convenient distance. Now, since it is square prism, it has got four sides, and all the four sides are equal, therefore 40, 40, 40, 40, I'll just divide this into four lateral edges. 40, 40, 40, 40, this is 40, again 40, 40, 40. Okay, I'll name this A, B, C, D, again A. So here this distance is 40 and this particular distance is 40 into 4, that is 160. Now the section plane is cutting the point A, or the lateral edge A, A1, at this particular point. So this itself is 1 dash, this is 1 dash, and the section plane is cutting the lateral edge B at this point, this is 2 dash, and here it is 3 dash, where the base edge BC is cutting with the section plane. So this is the point where the base edge is cutting the base edge, sorry, where the section plane is cutting the base edge BC at this point, that is 3 dash. Similarly, at this particular point, the section plane is cutting the base edge CD. There are two base edges here, okay, BC and CD. So in bracket 4 dash, 4 dash is the point where the section plane cuts the base edge CD or BC. Okay, so you must transfer the distances now. This is 1 dash, now this is 2 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash is, you need to measure the distance now from D to this particular point, that is 12.87, from D to this particular point. So from D to this, if I call this as X and this as Y, this should be X. And from B it is Y, so from B it is Y, this distance should be Y, where this is 3 dash and this is 4 dash. Now you need to join all the lines to get the development. From A to, from 1 dash to 2 dash, 2 dash through to 3 dash, 3 dash to 4 dash, again 4 dash to, there is D edge here, B and D, this line represents edge B as well as D, therefore one more edge will be there, which is 5 dash in bracket D, so this will be 5 dash. So 5 dash is the point where the section plane cuts the lateral edge B. 2 dash is the point where the lateral edge cuts the lateral, where the section plane cuts the lateral edge B. Okay, so 4 dash to 5 dash, 5 dash to 1 dash, sorry, yes, 1 dash or A, and we need to complete the development
and this is the retained portion of the lateral edge. This is the retained portion of the lateral edge, and this is the retained portion of the lateral edge that you must write it with a thick line. So this is the development of the said problem. Okay, the next problem number 7. It's on frustum of a square pyramid. Frustum means it is cut by a section plane which is parallel to HP, perpendicular to VP, not at an angle. The section plane parallel to HP and perpendicular to VP, that is what the frustum. A frustum of a square pyramid, base 40 mm, sides top 16 mm, sides and height 60 mm. Its axis is vertical and a side of its base is parallel to VP. Draw the projections of the frustum and show the development of the lateral surface of it. So this is the problem. So this is the top view and the front view of the said problem, where this is 40. It's a square pyramid, base 40 mm side, then top 16 mm. Top 16 means this one is 16 mm. I'll write this side. This is 16 and this is 40. Then the height 60 mm. So you must understand one thing, analyze one thing, that these three information, 40 mm, 16 mm and 60 mm, these three information is given with respect to the frustum. It is only with respect to the frustum, not with the height of the pyramid. Okay, so it is the frustum height is 60, not the axis height. So from here, if you just measure 60, it will somewhere come here. So this will be 16. From here to here, that will be 16. So this should be 60, not the entire height. Okay. Now this is 40. This is 16. You just join these two and you just extend this to get the apex, that is O dash. Okay, here the height of the axis is not given, instead the height of the frustum is given. So you need to extend the frustum to get the apex. Okay, I'll just write the dimensions in the left hand side so that I can able to get the true length in the right hand side. This is 16 and this is 40. Okay, so the retained portion now. The retained portion is only this amount. It is the frustum of a cone. This is the frustum of a cone. So this is the retained portion, and you must show the development of this particular retained portion. Okay, so the top view, retained portion of the top view will be something like this. The retained portion of the top view, after it is cut by the section plane, the retained portion of the top view of the square pyramid is something like this. This is the retained portion of the top view of the square pyramid, and this is the retained portion of the front view of the square pyramid. You must know the development of this. And in the case of pyramid, you must follow radial line method, where the radial line method, you can draw it anywhere. It is not essentially to be written just beside the front view of the pyramid or front view of the solid. As in the case of parallel line method, you can draw anywhere. Okay, you must have the true length now. Now just have a look at the front view and the top view. Is there a true length? I need to name it. First, this I will name it as A, B, C and D. Therefore, this becomes A dash in bracket D dash. This becomes B dash in bracket C dash. This is O, this is O1 dash. O dash, O1 dash.
Now just look at the lateral edge here. O dash, A dash, O dash, D dash, O dash, B dash, O dash, C dash. Is this in its true length? So we have the lines concept that if a line is parallel to one of the plane, you will get the true length of that in the other plane. That is what the lines concept. You just have a look at this is O, OA. This is not parallel to XY line. OB, again not parallel to XY line. OC, again not parallel to XY line. OD is not parallel to XY line. None of the lateral edges, slant edges, OA, OB, OC, OD is parallel to XY line. Therefore, you will not get the true length of this in the other view. So, what should we do? We should select any one of the edge first and we need to rotate that edge to make that edge parallel to XY line and then we need to project and then we need to get the true length. So, I will select the lateral edge OB here. I will write a horizontal line. I will write this B dash C dash this side, B dash C dash, okay. OB, I am going to rotate this OB by taking O as center, OB as radius, rotate OB, make this parallel. So, this becomes B1. So, OB1 is the lateral edge OB which is made parallel to XY line by rotating it. Now, extend this, so project this from this point, this is the B1 dash point. So, join this point with O dash, that will become the true length. So, this is the true length of the said pyramid. Okay. So, if you draw it for the square and if you measure the true length, then you will get the true length as 104. So, you need to rotate, make it parallel, project it and then get the true length. Okay. Now, where the section plane is cutting the lateral edges. The section plane here it is horizontal, since it here it is horizontal, no need to worry about the section plane. So, this is the section plane O, A, O, D. There are two edges here. So, 1 dash O, B here, 2 dash O, C here, 3 dash in bracket, O, D here, 4 dash in bracket. So, 1 dash is the point where the horizontal section plane cuts the lateral edge OA. 2 dash is the point where the horizontal section plane cuts the lateral edge OB. 3 dash is the point where the section plane cuts the lateral edge OC. Then, 4 dash is the point where the section plane cuts the slant edge OD. There are 4 slant edges OA, OB, OC, OD and the section plane is cutting all the 4 lateral edges at the point 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash. Now just project this to the true length line. This particular one is the new 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash and 4 dash. So you need to take this particular distance on the true length to transfer the distance to the development part. Okay. Now to draw the development part, so we know that this the true length is 104. So select any of the point and select any line here which is of 104. Okay, just draw a line for 104 true length. Then just take this as center, this as radius. You draw arc. Then since it is square, measure 40, 40, 40, 40, cut the distances 41, 42, 43 and 44. So this is A, B, C, D and A. This is the end point. So just join it with a thin line at the beginning. Okay. Then you must measure this particular distance also from here to here because this amount will be cut off by the section plane. Only this amount is the retained portion. This is cut off portion. So this is you must measure. If you measure this, if you write it to the scale, if you measure this, this you get it as 42.2. So measure 42.2 from this point, it will come up to something like this here. So this distance is 42.2. Now again, draw a curve from here to here. Again, no need to divide, just try to join this point with B, C, D. That will divide this particular curve like this. Okay? Fine. So this distance is representing 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, and 4 dash, where the section edge is section plane is cutting all the lateral edges. So this is the distance which is transferred here. Therefore, this should be the retained portion. Darken all the retained portion here to here. And since here it is the square edges, you need to draw lines from A to B, not the circle, not the curve, from B to C, from D to C to D, from D to A, and from this point to A, this point to A, where this is 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, and 1 dash. Then you need to join 1 dash to 2 dash, because here this is also square. This is not circle, this is also square. Since this is also square, you need to join with the straight lines between 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 1. And also 2 dash to B, this is the retained portion of the square pyramid, that is this one, retained portion of the square pyramid, retained portion. So you just darken all the retained portion of the square pyramid. So this is the development of said diagram. You just dimension it. This is 40 and this is 60. Okay, so this is the development of the said problem. Thank you.